technique is definitely a key.
Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to my channel. Today is the day, you guys. The labor has begun. So today is of course the 31st of March 2021, and I'm 2 days overdue. The baby was supposed to come on Monday, but here we are. Today is Wednesday. The good news is that my water broke this morning around 6:30 in the morning. So we called our hospital and they told us we can come in straight away. So yeah, we are here at the hospital at the moment, and it is currently now almost 5 o'clock in the evening, and so far we don't have the baby yet because nothing is happening. And yeah, so at the moment I'm just waiting to be taken to another room. This is of course the room that I'm going to be staying in once the baby is born, but in a few minutes we have to go to the delivery room because they have to give me something more like, you know, a medicine to help speed up the process because I don't have any contraction at the moment. So we'll be going there and get that one done and hopefully get this baby out of the tummy. So I'm quite excited.
So you guys, we came to this room here, which is of course the delivery room. Like I told you before, they are going to give me a tablet, which they already did, and that is going to just help speed up the process because, you know, since the water broke at 6:30 in the morning and we've been here short after that, nothing is happening, so they had to, you know, to do something to speed up the process. So yeah, this is the room we are in at the moment. So far I don't have any contractions at all, but we are here of course to monitor the baby to make sure that everything is all right. You can see over here of course we have the machine running, of course, the station for, you know, to check for the baby and all that good stuff. So yeah, I'm going to be here for a while they do that. And of course around me, I'm just going to quickly show you how this room looks like, which is of course the delivery room. You can see it's quite beautiful actually. But yeah, so over there you go towards the wall, we have the station for the baby, of course the scale and the heating up place over there that's getting ready. When the baby is here, we cannot wait. So yeah, this is where we are at the moment, waiting, counting time as to when this little one is going to arrive. But other than that, I'm doing all right. Of course, my husband is here with me. You know, we are just chilling and waiting. So yeah, I'll talk to you guys shortly. All right, you guys, so we are back to the delivery room, which is this one, of course. And they've just put the monitors to see on how the baby is doing, and so far everything is good. Of course I'm hooked to the IV over here, and you can see the contraction right here on how they are going. Yeah, so far the contraction started, which is quite lovely because we are making progress. It's better than before when we first arrived. Now I'm getting them like every 5 to 7 minutes, which is quite lovely. So yeah, they are not extremely intense, but I can definitely feel them. So yeah, we're just here waiting and see what happens. Hopefully this baby comes today, which is of course the 31st of March 2021. If he doesn't, well, probably tomorrow, but we are hoping for today. So yeah, right now I'm getting another contraction coming through. Not extremely big. I can talk through that one, but I can definitely feel it. Breathing technique is definitely a key, just to control your breathing. But anyway, you guys, so yeah, I'm just gonna stay here, chill and see what happens. I of course changed into my different outfit. All right, you guys, so we are in a different room now. They've moved us from the one that I showed you before to this one here because this one is a family room, which means we are getting a bigger bed, and my husband doesn't have to go home, so he can stay here with me of course, and you know, just for support. So yeah, it's a massive huge bed for two, which is quite lovely. My contractions, of course, they do come and go at the moment. They're becoming a little bit stronger, although I'm still at 1 centimeter dilated last time they checked me, and I have another one coming right now, and it's gonna be yeah, so they are becoming a little bit stronger, and yeah, but anyway, this is where we are going to spend the night. So now it's just a matter of, you know, trying to get some sleep. Of course, I told you guys before that they've given me medicine to kind of speed up the process, so that is definitely working, because now the contractions are becoming stronger and we are excited already to meet the baby. So yeah, here is the room tour if you are interested to see where we'll be sleeping. So over there we have the table, of course, and it is a huge room, definitely bigger than the other one that I showed you guys before with the outside view. But yeah, so I'll talk to you guys in the morning. I'm just going to try and get some sleep now.
Hey guys, look who we have here, the baby. Finally arrived. Say hello to the peeps, baby. Say hello to the peeps. Say hi, peeps. So you guys, so excited. The excitement is real at the moment. We finally have the baby. Thank God he's okay. He's doing great. So yeah, today is of course Monday, 5th of April, 2021. We've been here since last week, Wednesday. So it has been a while. We are still in the hospital, of course, and yeah, things did not really go according to the plan. Yeah, so after almost more than 15 hours of, you know, being in labor, of course, and the baby did not arrive. So the doctors had to do what they had to do, of course, for the safety of the baby and myself, because we had a bit of complications, of course. He had the cord stuck around his neck, and also he was facing the wrong position, so he couldn't really go through the, you know, the right, like a birth canal, or the right position. And they tried everything they could, you know, for that to happen, but unfortunately nothing was happening. So they had to go for the C-section, which means I had C-section to get the baby out, and the baby is doing great. I'm also doing great myself. I'm recovering very well, and yeah, so they decided to keep us in the hospital for 6 days, so we'll be, you know, going home on Wednesday, which is quite lovely. Today is Monday, so I still got a couple more days to stay in the hospital, and we'll be going home, which will be really wonderful, because I'm already getting exhausted of sitting in the hospital. But of course, you know, I have to stay here, you know, it's a baby, so that everything, you know, they monitor us to make sure that everything is all right. Father is over there playing with the baby, so that is fine. So yeah, you guys, that was my birth experience, and yeah, you just never know what happens, because you know, you don't really plan to have a C-section. You know, we're coming over here hoping to have a normal birth, but unfortunately that wasn't the case. And you know, at the end of the day, something needs to be done, you know, for the safety of everybody. So we just thank God that everything went well, and I'm recovering well. The baby is doing absolutely great, you know, already got used to the milk, because I'm actually breastfeeding. So yeah, everything is going absolutely wonderful. Oh, you guys, I'm going to show you our room over here, because they moved us again. They just keep changing the rooms again and again. So yeah, it's pretty much similar to the one that we had the other section, but I'll show you how, you know, the setup is over here. So I'll do that right now. Here we have, of course, the room tour for this room, you guys. So over here, it is a tray table where the food goes, and up there we have a
screen. You can watch TV if you want to, but I don't really use it. And right next to that, it is my bed. It is quite huge, isn't it? So yeah. And then right next to my bed, we have the baby's bed. You guys, look at that, so cute. The baby is currently sleeping at the moment. You can see in there. And of course, I brought my nursing pillow. So this pillow here, I did not bring it first time we came here because I thought I didn't need it. But later on, when the baby was here, I was like, you know what, I need the nursing pillow. So my husband went ahead and brought it, and I find it really good for nursing. So I'm happy it's here. So moving on to this section, of course, this is the changing station right here. So those drawers, we have all the nappies and everything that I need. And over here, I have all the, you know, the nappies, and not the nappy, the wipers, and I've got the hand sanitizer as well. And right there we have, like, you know, the rubbish and what is it, the washing, you know, the dead clothes for washing. And over here we have the changing place, so this can come off. Of course, you can put whatever you want to put here. They have like a different color that you can put in there, so wonderful. And then up there, that is the heating area. I find this one really cool, you guys, because you turn it on, it heats up the place so that the baby doesn't get too cold when you are changing them. That is a really good system up there, so you can turn on the light and of course and control the temperature when it comes to heating. So that is great. And down here we have, of course, the sitting area. You know, if you are tired of sitting on the bed, you can just come over here and chill. We have a table, two chairs, of course, and down there we have some water. And yeah, that is pretty much about this room, you guys. As you can see, just gonna put on the light so you can see a little bit more. Yeah, that's much more like it. There we go. And we have some pictures on the wall, the mirror over there, that's the entrance, the door. And this side here, we have another bed. It's a spare bed, there's nobody here. It's just me, so that is wonderful. And yeah, from this side here, that is how the room looks like. If we go further down, you can see right there, that is everything about this room, you guys. And then up there we have all the drawers, of course, with everything you need, from pads, you know, anything that you need. Basically, when we are here, you can find them in there, so that is wonderful. And this is the bathroom, you guys. You can see my shower shoes over there. I brought them with me, and they have been a lifesaver ever since. I do use them when I jump into the shower, so yeah, they're really, really handy. And over here we have all other things that are, of course, needed. If you wash your hair and you want to dry your hair, we have some tools over here. I have my towels over there, and of course my clothes for the shower as well. And I brought all my stuff, you can see over here, all my essentials, my shower gel, my creams, hand cream, of course, a Colgate toothbrush, and my deodorant, it all there. But anyway, this is how this area looks like. And we have, of course, the shower, which is over here, you can see. And then we have the toilet situation going on there. And we have this area here. So that is pretty much all the bathroom complete, you guys. All right, you guys, I had to put on a mask because my face was feeling so dry. And I have the avocado one from Revolution Skincare, which is this one here. And I love this avocado mask, you guys. My skin always loves it. And I decided to pop one on my face while I'm in the hospital, because yeah, I gotta do something. Okay, and so far my face feels really, really good. I'm loving this. It's actually ready to be washed, so yeah, I wasn't sure when I was packing this mask whether I'm going to actually use it, because you know, after giving birth, so it's time for mask, you know. But here we are, the mask is on, and I'm glad that I did pack it, because my skin really needed it. Yeah, it's definitely already getting dry, so that is wonderful. All right, I'm going to wash it off and get ready for bed. Hey baby, are you excited to go home? Say hi peeps, I'm excited to go home. I'm excited to go home. So you guys, right now we are just waiting for my husband. I called him to say the doctor was here, and they did the final checkup. Of course, everything is good, and we are going home. So he's on his way to come pick us up. The baby had a shower, dressed up, looking cute, and we are super excited. I mean, after being here for like 6 days, it is time to go home. We miss home, of course.
The staff here in the hospital, they have been absolutely amazing, super professional, and the service was absolutely great. So yeah, just awesome hospital and awesome staff members, which we are super happy with the experience that we had over here at this hospital. But yeah, and one thing we need to do before we go home, of course, the doctor said we have to take this little baby to check the ears, of course, and for that we don't have to travel that far because it is within the hospital, just like a few rooms from where we are, and from there we'll go home, of course. So yeah, we have all the paperwork done and everything and ready to go. So super exciting. I just want to say thank you so much if you've been watching this labor and delivery video from the beginning. When we came here, it was just my husband and I, of course, and now we are going, three of us. We have this beautiful little baby that we have to look after, and it is exciting time for us, but I'm pretty sure everything will be okay. And yeah, there'll be a lot of things, a lot of learning to do, because this is of course our first baby. And I mean, you learn as you go, I guess. So we just take it as it comes. But yeah, thank you so much for watching. I hope this video was helpful and hope you enjoyed it. As always, go have a good one. Take care of yourself out there. And we shall catch you on our next video. Aren't we, baby? Aren't we? Yeah? We're going to catch the poops on our next video, yeah? All right, guys. Take care. Bye-bye.